Yo, what's going on, everyone? This is Austin from Calling Our Shot, and today we're back for some more fantasy football videos. And what are we talking about today? We're talking about when you should draft a quarterback in your fantasy football league draft. Now, there's several different strategies. We'll break them down. I'll give you my favorite strategy to go with. Now, we're also going to talk about two quarterback leagues or super flex leagues, as those are more or less pretty similar. But first, we're going to talk about standard one quarterback league, because that's what the majority of you guys will be drafting in. But first, be sure to smash that like button and smash that subscribe button. We really appreciate it. You guys have been killing the support, not only these videos, but Logan's videos as well. So we can't say thank you enough. We're trying to take Calling Our Shot to the moon. As Logan mentioned yesterday, speaking of the moon, shout out to our newest sponsor, MoonBet. Now, we all love football. We all love sports betting. And that's probably why you're here, why you're subscribed to the Calling Our Shot channel. Or you better be subscribed soon, because we've got a lot of cool content coming your way. But if you ever wanted to become an owner of a sports book, I would probably say yes. Well, look no further. MoonBet is the first platform that allows you to become an owner of a sportsbook in a casino. Now, you even earn a percentage of the profits and revenue that they bring in. Now, with the MoonBet sportsbook and casino launching later this month, get in now while you still can. Now, we have a referral link, which will give you a discount. A couple of people signed up yesterday, so shout out to those people. But click the referral link down below. You get a discount. And you can sign up before it's too late. Today is the last day. Now, they'll have another sale coming up, I believe, soon before they officially launch it out. But you'll want to make sure you join now before it's too late. The best price is now, so make sure you get in there now. Click that link in the description. But shout out to MoonBet again for sponsoring the video. Now we're talking about fantasy football, and there's two different strategies you could take when drafting a quarterback in fantasy football. One, you could draft a quarterback early in your draft. You say, you know what? I want Patrick Mahomes. I'm in. Or two, you could wait until later to draft a quarterback, which is my preferred method. But we'll talk about both of them. Now, starting with the first strategy, by no means am I saying drafting Patrick Mahomes at pick 20 in your fantasy football draft is a bad idea. Having Patrick Mahomes is arguably one of the most fun players to have on your team. You get to watch him every single Sunday, and you're like, heck yeah, this guy's an absolute beast. So now you have Mahomes on your team. You got a set it and forget it quarterback, or maybe even a Josh Allen at pick 30 or Kyler Murray at pick 40. All these guys, super good. And normally, these guys, sadly, are not on a lot of my teams because normally I'm avoiding them. And it's not because I think they're bad. It's because I don't think it's the best strategy for when you're drafting your fantasy football teams to get the best value. Now, my preferred method is waiting. Now, I'm not saying to wait until the end. You're starting, I don't know, like a Derek Carr or a Zach Wilson, which shout out to the New York Jets. But those aren't the guys I want to be leading my fantasy football roster, but I do want to wait and not draft those elite top guys because I don't think there's great value at that position. Now, let's talk about it in terms of points per game for fantasy points. Now, you see at Mahomes, you got him at pick number 19.5, and then you got a guy like Justin Herbert all the way at pick 70. Now, that's a big difference, and this is a guy like Justin Herbert, second year in the Chargers offense, and he averaged 2.5 points less than Mahomes last year. Yeah, that's not a big difference, yet they're going 50 picks apart. Now, even Ryan Tannehill, I know, not the sexiest quarterback out there. Maybe you think he's a good-looking guy. I don't know. But this guy is still going almost 80 picks later than him. Tannehill finished as QB7 last year, averaging 22 points per game, whereas Mahomes averaged 25.3 points per game. And he was about a top 10 quarterback ever since he got that position, the quarterback position for the Tennessee Titans. Now, there's a ton of depth at the QB position, which is why I'm saying to stop and not draft a guy super early. Now, you still can. Like I said, it's your draft, but here's the analysis. Now, last season, the difference between QB1 all the way down to QB10, it was less than 4 points per game, 4 fantasy points per game. Now, the difference between, because you're going to be foregoing, let's say you draft a Mahomes and Allen, you're going to be foregoing one of those top running backs, wide receivers off the board, maybe even a tight end. Now, the difference between the number one running back and the number 10 running back last year was a full 10 fantasy points per game, probably even more in PPR since I'm just splitting in the middle and doing half PPR. Now, you talk about it, but back in 2019, that difference was, again, 10 fantasy points between the RB1 and RB10. For wide receivers, same exact story. 2020, 8-point difference between wide receiver 1 and wide receiver 10. 2019, 6-point difference. There's a big difference in drafting guys like, you know, a Mahomes or an Allen or a Kyler Murray. You're moving around or a tier lower on each positional group, which is normally not something I'm doing. Like, if you take a Mahomes at pick 20, you're foregoing guys like Calvin Ridley, DK Metcalf, Najee Harris, AJ Brown, Antonio Gibson. All these guys are going to be really good this year, and you're dropping back to another tier of guys like a David Montgomery or a Miles Sanders or a DeAndre Swift. Not that those guys are bad, or maybe even a Ja'Marr Chase. Not even that those guys are bad. They're still very good players. They'll probably be good in fantasy, but it's a little bit more uncertainty. You don't feel as great starting those guys as opposed to, you know, like an AJ Brown or a Calvin Ridley or DK Metcalf, one of those guys that is projected in the top 10 of wide receivers. Now, hence, that's why I'm going later in drafts. Now, if you wait to draft a guy like Herbert and picks at pick 70, like round 6 or 7, You probably have 5-6 good picks. You have 2-3 solid great running backs, 2-3 solid good receivers, and maybe you have a tight end, which that position group is very, very shallow. Now, that's why I'm waiting to draft one. Now, let's say you took a QB early. Now you're going to be relying on a starter at a wide receiver or running back position like a Jamar Chase. We already talked about him. Kareem Hunt, Odell Beckham Jr., Kenny Golladay. None of these guys I really want to be starting or relying on in my fantasy football leagues, unless it's a super deep league. But we're just assuming you're in a 10, 12 team league, maybe even an 8. I'm still waiting to draft a quarterback. Let me know your favorite draft strategy for QBs. Now we're going to talk about two quarterback leagues, because these are completely different than a regular snake draft. And shout out to the guy that commented on my video asking me to talk about it. And I'll break down. I'll give you my quick thoughts. These are for two QB leagues or a SuperFlex league. Now, I will say I'm not in a ton of two quarterback leagues, just because, you know, it's a lot of more people are more common with one QB leagues. And I'm fine playing in those. Now, my strategy in these sort of drafts, got to get a quarterback early, at least one quarterback early. Now, you might not get Mahomes because you're going to need a top probably 1 or 3 pick to get a Mahomes. But you got to take a guy like Josh Allen or a Kyler Murray. Or a Dak Prescott or a Russell Wilson or Aaron Rodgers. Those are guys I'm targeting as my QB1. I want one of those guys especially. Now, my strategy in these, you're going to get that QB1, and then I'm okay taking a QB later. Now, in this league, QBs come at a premium, especially if you're in a 12 to 16 team league. You're talking about guys having to start guys like Daniel Jones or Derek Carr or Kirk Cousins. I can't lie to you. I don't want to be starting any of those guys unless it's maybe a bye week fill-in. Now, I'm normally a guy, there's some value. I will admit there's some value in two QB leagues, especially with a guy like Ryan Fitzpatrick. Now, not saying I do not want to have Ryan Fitzpatrick as my QB1. This is a guy like Ryan Fitzpatrick. He's going around pick 71, round 6. I don't mind having him leaving my draft with like a Prescott and a Fitzpatrick. I'm happy. I'm happy with that. I took Prescott with one of my first 1-2 picks, and then it's like a guy like Ryan Fitzpatrick in round 6. Now those other 4 or 5 picks in between, I'm gonna load it up with some good, like 2 good running backs, 3 good receivers, and I'm pretty set. I'd probably stick to drafting a guy like Trey Lance or maybe a Justin Fields later on in the draft, just because, you know, those guys have the chance to blossom to top 10 QB, just like Justin Herbert did last year. That guy was absolutely insane, and he was a free agent for majority of the year in majority, not 2 QB leagues, but even then out there, he was probably a free agent. Now, in summary, I prefer one QB early and then one quarterback a little bit later, right around that Jalen Hurts, Joe Burrow, Trevor Lawrence kind of area. I don't really want to be going to the Matt Ryans of the world, but he's going to be going in the same way. Now, that's my strategy when you're talking about, you know, yeah, there's also another strategy. You could draft a guy super late. You could draft a QB like round 5 or 6, and then you would have gotten 2-3 stud running backs at great value and 2-3 stud wide receivers at good value. Just not my preferred strategy. Like I said, you're going to be relying on a Matt Ryan or Baker Mayfield as your QB1. I don't really want that. I want to set it and forget it QB1. Now, I'm fine with a guy like Ryan Fitzpatrick. Maybe take another third guy. I don't know. You name it. Tua Tagovailoa is going a little too high. I don't know. Maybe even a guy like Daniel Jones or a Zach Wilson. You don't really know, with those guys going much later as my QB3. Either way, I think you guys will want it. And now, there is a cool website. I'll link them down below. It gives you the ADP of every top of 2 quarterback leagues for 10 team leagues and 12 team leagues. It was pretty cool. That's how I really learned, you know, because I haven't done a 2 QB league draft this year. But it let me learn, you know, where are these guys going in what round. And that told me that Ryan Fitzpatrick was a round 6, round 7 guy. And I really like that value for a guy like him, who I think will be in a Washington offense that will be much better than people anticipate. But I'll put that link down below. Thanks again. Shout out to Rubet, or not Rubet, that's a betting site. Shout out to MoonBet for sponsoring the video. We appreciate you guys. You guys are absolute best. Thanks for, if you want to click that link in the description for a discount, get your MoonBet tokens, go for it. $1 will give you 20,000 tokens. It's a steal of a lifetime. This has been awesome. I'll catch you guys again tomorrow. We're talking about the AFC South, so buckle in. We got a lot more videos coming up this week and for the next couple weeks as football approaches. Preseason has been fun to watch. It's been awesome. I'll catch you guys again soon. Peace.